So, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and my privilege to greet you all welcome to this ISDP forum on the outcome of the National Congress of the Communist Party of China. My name is Per Eklund. I'm a senior fellow at ISDP and also member of the board of ISDP. As you know, the party congress takes place every 5 years, and it is the highest body within the Communist Party. This year's congress saw the election of 5 new members to the standing committee of the Politburo, along with the re-election of President Xi Jinping and Prime Minister Gui Congyou. This happened in the world's second largest economy, and it makes it an important event to analyze. If you are tweeting, you find there, feel free to tag us at ISDP_Sweden and use our hashtag ISDP Forum shown on the screen below. This forum is divided into two parts. First, we have His Excellency, the Chinese Ambassador to Sweden, as a keynote speaker. And after which, he will take a few questions from the audience. And after the keynotes, there will be a panel discussion with panelists on China from different institutions in Sweden. Ambassador Gui Congyou of China was born in 1965. He has a Master of Law degree and is quite a recent arrival to Stockholm. He took up duty here in August this year. And prior to this posting, he was Director General of the Department of European Central Asian Affairs at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in China, and he's also served at the Chinese embassy in Moscow. Mr. Ambassador, I invite you to take the floor following this brief introduction. You're most welcome.
Thank you for your kind introduction.
正如主持人刚才说的，我是到瑞典上任五十多天。
I've only come to Sweden for about 50 days.
我对出任中国驻瑞典大使感到非常荣幸。
I'm very honored to be here.
因为瑞典是第一个从中国建立外交关系的西方国家，也是在西方国家中率先从中国开展经贸、科技。 文化和军事友好交流的国家，为中国发展和建设，为提高人民生活水平，做出了重要贡献。
I'm very honored to be the Chinese ambassador of Sweden because Sweden is the first Western country to establish diplomatic ties with China and to conduct cooperation in various areas with China. It has contributed greatly to China's economic and social development.
那么，首先我要代表中国政府向瑞典政府和人民，几十年来，从中国开展友好合作，为中国发展所做的友好贡献，我们表示衷心的感谢。First,
on behalf of the Chinese government, I'd like to thank our Swedish friends and the Swedish government for your friendship and cooperation with China and your contribution to China's development.
那么，各位朋友，中国政府派我来的主要任务就是和瑞典社会各界。 积极对话，加深理解，增进互信，促进合作。
And so my main task here is to enhance mutual understanding and dialogue and improve cooperation with the Swedish counterparts.
中国共产党十九大的顺利召开，是中国发展建设进入了一个新时代，这个中日两国的友好合作带来了新的机遇。
The convention of the 19th National Congress of the CPC has brought new opportunities for China-Sweden cooperation and friendship.
那么今天这样的活动为我向大家介绍十九大的情况，也为促进我们双方之间的相互了解，提供了很好的机会。
So today's event is a good platform for me to introduce to you the 19th National Congress and the opportunities we face in future cooperation.
那么再次感谢主持人的邀请，也感谢各位朋友的到来。
Again, thank you for your invitation and for your attendance in this event.
那么确实像主持人讲的，十九大引起了国际社会广泛关注。
Just as the MC has said, the 19th National Congress of CPC has attracted wide attention from the international community.
那么这次大会分析了国际、国内形势发展变化，做出了中国特色社会主义进入形势代的重大判断，选举产生了新一届中央领导机构，绘制出了中国未来一个时期的大战方针和战略部署，对于实现中国人民对美好生活的向往，对于世界人民的共同发展具有重要意义，是中国人民的福音，也是。
The Congress has discussed developments in both domestic and international situations and made the significant judgment that socialism with Chinese characteristics has entered a new era. A new central leadership was elected, and major policies and strategies for China's development in the coming period were formulated. The Congress is significant for realizing the Chinese people's aspirations for a better life and the common development of people across the world. It has brought good news for people in China and beyond.
大会发出了中国共产党人讲牢记初心和使命的时代响应。中国共产党已经走过九十六年的光辉岁月，领导中国人民站起来、富起来、强起来，成就举世瞩目。同时，我们也绝不会忘记当时为什么出发。The
Congress sent a strong message that Chinese communists will keep firmly in mind their original aspiration and mission. CPC has gone down a glorious journey of 96 years and led the Chinese people to stand up, grow rich, and become strong. This is a historic achievement recognized by the whole world. Nonetheless, we will never forget where we started.
这就是为中国人民谋幸福，为中华民族谋复兴，这是我们的初心和使命，也是我们的理想和信念。
That is, to seek happiness for the Chinese people and rejuvenation for the Chinese nation. This is our original aspiration and mission, and also our ideal and faith.
96年来，一代又一代共产党人为使英勇奋斗，成就成千上万烈士，献出了宝贵生命。敌人只能砍下我们的头颅，却不能动摇我们的信仰。这就是他们的誓言，是中国共产党人永不褪色的红色基因。
Over the past 96 years, generation after generation of CPC members have fought bravely for this ideal, and thousands upon thousands of martyrs have given their lives. As they pledged, the enemy can hack off our heads, but never shake our beliefs. This has been the everlasting tradition of revolution of Chinese communists.
当前，中国发展前景十分光明，挑战也十分严峻。但只要我们深深扎根中国人民，紧紧依靠人民，就可以获得无穷的力量，风雨无阻，风雨向前。
At present, China's development is faced with bright prospects, but also severe challenges. As long as we firmly align ourselves with the people and rely on them, we can and will have boundless energy to forge ahead, come rain or shine.
因为历史是人民书写的，正所谓得众者得众者得国，失众者失国。中国共产党人将永远与人民同呼吸、共命运、心连心，永远把人民对美好生活的向往作为创造目标。
Because people are the creators of history, as the saying goes, he who wins over the people wins the country, he who loses the people loses the country. Chinese communists will always breathe the same breath as the people, share the same future, and stay truly connected to them. We will always make the aspirations of the people to live a better life the focus of our efforts and accomplish the grand blueprints drawn at the 19th Party Congress.
十九大确立了习近平新时代中国特色社会主义思想。经过长期不懈努力，中国共产党稳定解决了十几亿中国人的温饱问题，总体上实现小康。中国社会主要矛盾已经转化为人民日益增长的美好生活需要和不平衡、不充分的发展之间的矛盾。
At the Congress, the Xi Jinping thought on socialism with Chinese characteristics for a new era was enshrined. With decades of hard work, the CPC has ensured that the basic needs of over a billion people are met and have basically made it possible for people to live decent lives. The principal contradiction facing Chinese society has evolved. What we now have is the contradiction between unbalanced and inadequate development and the people's ever-growing needs for a better life.
人民美好生活需求日益广泛，不仅对物质文化生活提出了更高要求，而且在民主、法治、公正、正义、安全、环境等方面的要求也日益增长。
The needs to be met for the people to live a better life are increasingly broader. Not only have their material and cultural needs grown, their demands for democracy, rule of law, fairness and justice, security and a better environment are increasing.
那么中国经济社会科技水平整体上显著提高，在航空航天、高铁、互联网、人工智能等很多方面进入世界前列。更加突出的问题是发展不平衡不充分。
The scientific and technological level of China's economy and society has been significantly improved. China is leading the world in many fields such as aerospace, high-speed railways, the internet, and artificial intelligence.The more prominent problem facing China is its unbalanced and inadequate development.
在中国东部地区和北京、上海等一些大城市，发展水平同西方发达国家差不多，甚至超过了西方一些发达国家的水平。但在农村和中西部地区，经济社会发展还比较落后。
China's eastern region and big cities such as Beijing and Shanghai have almost become as developed as or even more developed than Western countries.But its rural areas and central and western regions are still underdeveloped.
中国还有几千万人口尚未脱贫，城市还有很多困难群众。会议决定，我们要在继续推动发展的基础上，大力提升发展质量和效益，更好地推动人的全面发展和社会的全面进步。
There are still tens of millions of people in China stuck in poverty and many urban people living in difficulty.The 19th Party Congress has decided that while building on efforts to sustain development, we must push hard to improve the quality and efficiency of growth so as to promote well-rounded human development and all-round social progress.
在新时代，我们将牢牢坚持以人民为中心，牢牢坚持中国共产党的领导，人民当家作主，依法治国，有机统一。
In this new era, we will stay firmly committed to the people-centered approach and the organic unity of CPC leadership, the people running the country, and law-based governance.
我们将继续发展社会主义、协商民主，保障人民当家作主，落实到国家政治生活和社会生活之中。
We will develop socialist consultative democracy and ensure that the principle of the people running the country is put into practice in China's political and social activities.
我们要加强人权法治保障，保证人民依法享有广泛权利和自由，保障人民知情权、参与权、表达权和监督权。
We will strengthen legal protection for human rights to situate that the people enjoy extensive rights and freedoms as prescribed by law. We will ensure the people's rights to be informed, to participate, to be heard, and to oversee.
我们要坚持在发展中保障和改善民主。在发展中补齐民生短板，促进社会公平正义。
We will continue using development to ensure and improve people's well-being and strengthen areas of weakness and promote social fairness and justice.
到2020年，建成一个经济更加发达、民主更加健全、教育更加进步、文化更加繁荣、社会更加和谐、人民生活更加殷实的小康社会。
By 2020, we will have developed our society into a moderately prosperous one with a stronger economy, greater democracy, more advanced science and education, thriving culture, greater social harmony, and a better quality of life.
那么在此基础上，再奋斗15年到2035年，基本建成社会主义现代化。
After this, with another 15 years of work, we will have basically achieved modernization in 2035.
再奋斗十五年，到本世纪中叶，把中国建成富强、民主、文明、和谐、美丽的社会主义强国。到那时，全体中国人民共同富裕基本实现。
With another more 15 years of work, we will have turned China into a great modern socialist country that is prosperous, strong, democratic, culturally advanced, harmonious, and beautiful. By that time, the common prosperity for every Chinese people is basically achieved.
在这个新时代，我们中国将日益走进世界舞台中心，不断为人类做出更大贡献。
In this new era, we will move closer to center stage and make greater contribution to mankind.
中国共产党既是为中国人民谋福利的政党，也是为人类、为全人类进步事业奋斗的政党。
The CPC strives for both the well-being of the Chinese people and human progress.
当今世界各国相互联系和依存日益加深，同时不稳定性、不确定性突出，人类面临许多共同挑战。包括世界经济增长动能不足、贫富分化日益严重、恐怖主义、气候变化等非传统安全威胁持续蔓延等。
Nowadays, countries are becoming increasingly interconnected and interdependent, and yet as a world we face growing uncertainties and destabilizing factors, mankind is facing many common challenges. Global economic growth lacks energy.The gap between rich and poor continues to widen, and unconventional security threats like terrorism and climate change continue to spread.
中国呼吁各国人民同心、同力协心，构建人类命运共同体，建设持久和平、普遍安全、共同繁荣、开放包容、清洁美丽的世界。
China calls on the people of all countries to work together to build a community of shared future for mankind.And an open, inclusive, clean, and beautiful world that enjoys lasting peace, universal security, and common prosperity.
中国坚持走和平发展道路，坚定奉行独立自主的和平外交政策，维护国际公平正义，反对干涉他国内政，反对以强凌弱。
China will stay on the path of peaceful development and remain firm in pursuing an independent foreign policy of peace. China endeavors to uphold international fairness and justice.And oppose interference in the internal affairs of others, as well as the practice of the strong bringing the weak.
中国无论发展到什么程度，都永远不称霸，永远不搞扩张。
No matter what stage of development it reaches, China will never seek hegemony or engage in expansion.
那么，中国对外开放的大门将越开越大。
China will only become more and more open to the world.
我们将积极发展全球伙伴关系。积极促进“一带一路”国际合作，推动建设开放型世界经济。
We will actively develop global partnerships, promote international cooperation through the Belt and Road Initiative, and work to build an open world economy.
中国将继续发挥负责任大国作用，倡导国际关系民主化，支持联合国发挥积极作用。
China will continue to play its part as a major and responsible country, stand for democracy in international relations, and support the UN in playing an active role in international affairs.
我们将积极参与全球治理体系改革和建设，与国际社会合力应对气候变化、恐怖主义、核扩散等国际热点问题和全球性挑战，不断为此贡献中国智慧和力量。
We will take an active part in reforming and developing the global governance system, work with the international community to address climate change, terrorism, nuclear proliferation, and other international hotspot issues and global challenges, and keep contributing Chinese wisdom and strength.
各位朋友，正如我开展白中讲到，中国政府和人民始终牢记，瑞典是第一个同中华人民共和国建交的西方国家。中国改革开放之后，瑞典又在西方国家中率先的中国签订经贸。协定和投资保护协定，并开展科技合作和人文军事友好交流，为中国经济社会发展做出了积极贡献。
Dear friend, just as I have said just now, the Chinese government and people have always remembered that Sweden was the first Western country to establish diplomatic ties with China. After the start of China's reform and opening up, Sweden went on to become the first Western country to sign a trade agreement and investment protection agreement with China.And actively engage in economic, cultural, and technological cooperation between our two countries, making positive contribution to China's economic and social development.
尊瑞友好合作有悠久传统良好基础和深厚潜力为了满足中国人民对美好生活日益广泛的需求中瑞在创新绿色经济节能环保高端制造共同应对气候变化等领域转进来更广阔机遇
China-Sweden friendship and cooperation has a long tradition, sound foundation and great potential. To meet the Chinese people's ever-growing needs for a better life,China-Sweden cooperation in innovation, green economy, energy conservation and environment protection, high-end manufacturing and other areas will embrace broader opportunities.
我们欢迎瑞典各界全面客观看待当代中国和中国共产党牢记中瑞两国建交初心在相互尊重公平正义互利共赢基础上向中国各界扩大交流深化合作为两国人民乃至世界人民
We welcome Swedish friends from all walks of life to look at modern China and CPC in a comprehensive and objective manner. Stay true to our original aspirations when we establish diplomatic relations and expand exchanges and deepen cooperation with Chinese counterparts on the basis of mutual respect, fairness, and reciprocity to bring more benefits to people in our two countries and the people across the world.
尊敬的各位朋友，从我刚才介绍的中国共产党的思想主张方针和政策和实践看我们不难得出结论中国共产党领导的中国是世界和平的建设者是全球发展的贡献者也是国际秩序和规则的维护者
If we look at the thoughts, philosophy, principles, policies and practice of CPC it's not difficult to draw the conclusion that China under the leadership of CPC is a contributor to world peacefacilitator of global development and proponent of international order and rules.
我预祝本次研讨会取得圆满成功，谢谢大家。
I wish this forum a full success. Thank you.
谢谢 Ambassador for giving us this keynote speech and using us to the conclusions of the party congress.We have time for a few questions from the audience. Lady on the second row.
Mr. Ambassador, welcome to Sweden and thank you for your speech. In the second Congress with President Xi,We learned that China will be more aggressive on the global stage. That means China will be more involved in international relations. Yet at the same time, you have a policy not to interfere in internal business in different countries. How will you apply the new policy or the new ambition of President Xi? Thank you.
谢谢你的欢迎听到你的欢迎 我心里暖和和的
Thank you for your question I feel、delighted by your question
因为我八月十八号到瑞典之前我没来过瑞典跟瑞典人民没打过交道我心里非常忐忑不安、
Because、before I came to Sweden on 18th August I've never come here and I feel、really nervous
但是我到了瑞典以后这五十多天来我见到的所有瑞典朋友对我都非常友好非常热情是我切身感受到瑞典人民两国人民之间的友好感情
But in the past 50 days the Swedish people have always been friendly and warmly to me so I feel the friendship between China and Sweden is very strong
那么您刚才提的问题中国这个日益走向世界舞台的中心和不干涉内政，二者一点不矛盾。
And regarding your question, I think China's getting closer to the center stage is not in contradiction with China's peaceful foreign policy and non-interference in others' internal affairs.
那么，正如主持人刚才讲的，我们中国以稳住经济、稳住世界第二，那么 中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国的这个自由贸易协定，中国
in the world, and its overall national strength has improved greatly. And even some foreigners say that maybe someday China will surpass America.
那么确实，中国还会不断发展强大，我们要作为强国。但是我感觉，在我的有生之年，我看不到中国超越美国成为世界第一。
And indeed, I think China will continue to develop and become a strong country. But I think in my lifetime, I will not see the day when China should surpass America.
那么我刚才讲的中国走在世界、走进世界舞台的中心，主要有几个方面的含义。
There are several meanings for China's getting closer to center stage.
首先，中国要在世界经济发展中，发挥更大的作用。通过自身的发展，通过把本国建成这个社会主义现代化强国，使前到本世纪中叶，使中国人民，使中国，在发展水平达到西方中等发达国家的水平，这样为世界。为整个世界的发展做出自己的贡献。
First, China will play an active role in promoting economic development in the whole world, by developing ourselves, by building ourselves into a strong modern socialist country, and by improving our people's living standards greatly, we will contribute to world development.
中国人口占世界的五分之一。如果中国经济社会不发展，陷入停滞，如果中国人民的生活水平得不到提高，那显然整个世界经济的发展，整个世界人民的生活水平的提高就受到很大的限制。
And China's population accounts for 1/5 of the world's total. So if China's social and economic development is in a bad status and the Chinese people's living standards is not being improved,That will cause a big problem for the human progress of the whole world.
我知道瑞典，早就成为西方发达国家，人均 GDP 超过5000多，这个处在世界发展的顶峰，最上层吧。
I know that Sweden is a much developed country. It's on the top of the world.
那么，我知道，瑞典也非常有国际责任感，一直在。自己发展的同时，积极帮助其他国家发展。
I also know that Sweden is a country with a strong sense of responsibility in the international community. It is always helping other countries to develop as well.
一些瑞典朋友跟我说，中国是大国，瑞典是小国。我不太同意这种看法。实际上，瑞典在人均无论是人均 GDP 还是对世界所做的发展所做的贡献来讲。都是一个世界大国。
And some people said to me that China is a big country while Sweden is a small country, but I do not agree with them. I think, in terms of per capita GDP or the contribution to world economic development, Sweden is a very big country.
瑞典在积极的为世界发展做贡献。那么，如果占世界人口五分之一的中国不自己发展起来，自己发展起来以后，不为其他国家的发展做贡献，那我们就拖了瑞典人民的后腿。
So Sweden is making great contribution to the world development. And if Chinese people with 1/5 of the world total population do not develop ourselves and contribute to world development, we are lagging behind and we are a burden to Sweden.
中国日益走进世界舞台的中心，首要的任务就是要和包括瑞典在内的各国一道推动全人类的发展事业。
So the main task of China as a country getting closer to center stage is to work with the international community, including Sweden, to promote human progress in the whole world.
那么中国日益走进世界舞台的中心，第二个要承担的角色就是要维护世界和平。
And our second task is to safeguard world peace.
那么人类爆发了两次世界大战，给人类社会发展带来巨大的灾难，使全人类发展倒退几十年。这是我们极不愿意看到的，我们极不愿意看到世界大战再次发生。
The two world wars have caused, it is a major disaster for the human world. It has caused suffering and many problems for our society. It is, we never want to see another world war happen again.
那么五年来，各种地区性、区域性冲突增长了65%，那么也给地区人民、给世界人民带来了不少的挑战和困难。
So in the past years, regional conflicts have risen by 65%, which has causing great problems and difficulties for people in the region and in the whole world.
那么曾几何时，叙利亚难民，成为一个全球性的话题，也给包括瑞典在内的这个欧洲各国，带来新的这个挑战。
And for example, the refugees in Syria has posed a great threat to all the people in the world, including Sweden and China, and it is a global issue.
还有在我们的南部周边也出现了几十万的难民。
And there are thousands of refugees in our neighboring countries.
都是给地区国家乃至世界各国的发展，带来挑战和问题，这是我们极不愿看到的。所以，中国日益走向世界舞台的中心，要承担的角色就是维护世界和平。
We do not want these refugees and other conflicts to pose great challenges and threat to the regional countries and the world. So our second largest role is to safeguard the world peace.
中国拒绝任何国家干涉中国内政，也绝不会干涉任何一个国家的内政。
China refuses any country to interfere in our internal affairs, and we will never interfere in another country's internal affairs.
那么对于世界，对于不同一些地方，出现的影响世界和平和发展的问题，我们怎么办？中国绝对不会通过单方面干预来解决，而是要在联合国框架内，按照联合国宪章，通过联合国会员国、安理会成员国、联合会员国集体协商来解决。
So, when we face conflicts in any region of the country, we will never interfere in another country's internal affairs to resolve them. We will work under the UN framework and obey the UN charter, and through consultation and cooperation with other UN members to solve the problems.
那么这一点，我们中瑞两国也高度一致。那么瑞典是积极参与联合国框架内的各项事务，而且。瑞典还成功的当选2017至2018年联合国安理会非常任理事国。中瑞两国在这个联合国安理会框架内，在整个联合国事务中都合作得很好。我们通过不干涉他国内政方法，成功的解决了许多问题。这是解决国际和地区问题的一个成功的这个道路。
China and Sweden has reached great consensus on this front. I want to congratulate Sweden to be elected as a non-permanent member of the UN Security Council in 2017 to 2018. Actually, we have conducted a great cooperation within the UN framework, and we have addressed many problems through the non-interference policy.
我不知道你满意不满意。
I don't know if you.
如果不满意，我们可以单独讨论。OK， 还有问题吗
？Thank you again, Mr. Ambassador, for highlighting the challenges that lies ahead and the prospects, indeed, that also lies ahead.